What's the difference between Outlook, Outlook, and Outlook.com? Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. And heaven help me, this is going to be an interesting one because Microsoft has almost gone out of their way to confuse the heck out of us with their naming conventions. So what I want to do is I want to run through the various uses of the products and services Microsoft calls Outlook to make sure that we understand exactly which one we're talking about when we use the word. Outlook actually refers to three separate and unrelated things. That's frustrating because when you say Outlook, say you're asking me a question, I don't know which of the three you're referring to. And of course, the answers and scenarios are completely different depending on which Outlook it is you're talking about. So let's walk through the three. The first one is Outlook, the program. That is a piece of software that comes with Microsoft Office that you install on your PC and configure to access your email. You can configure it to access email from any email service that supports POP3 and IMAP. Then there's Outlook, the other program. If you've run the mail program in Windows 10 or Windows 11, you may have experienced this title bar, this bar across the top saying that Mail and Calendar is about to be replaced by Outlook. That Outlook, which you can opt into by switching the little switch to use the new Outlook, is a completely different program than the Outlook that comes with Microsoft Office. It's still called Outlook, but it is a separate program. It is a program that is installed on your computer. It's an email program that downloads your messages to your computer. You can configure it to use any email account from any provider that supports POP3 or IMAP, and it includes an address book and a calendar and so forth. But it's a separate and different program. So I'm going to refer to these two programs as Microsoft Office Outlook and Microsoft Windows Outlook. And I want to now show you the two programs. So over here in Windows 11, I actually have them both installed. And yes, you can have them both installed. If I just search for Outlook, you'll see that it comes up twice in my search results. Outlook the app, and then this other Outlook. Outlook the app happens to be Microsoft Office Outlook. And you can tell that the way I distinguish between the two is that it has a file menu. Because as we'll see in a minute, when I fire up the other Outlook, the Outlook that if you take a closer look at it, it has this little, I think it's a beta moniker down at the bottom of the icon. If we click on that, that's a separate program. It's a program running on my PC. And in fact, you can see that I have two different Outlook icons in the taskbar indicating that I have two different programs running. And those two different programs are Outlook and Outlook. Or more correctly, on the left-hand side, Microsoft Office Outlook, and on the right-hand side, Microsoft Windows Outlook. I'm hoping that this represents a transition, that at some point, things will move to a single unified email program. However, until then, this is very, very confusing. So, those are the two most confusing Outlooks. There's another one. I'm going to fire up my browser real quick here. And this time I'm going to Outlook.com. Outlook.com is a website. It is not a program on your machine. It is a website. You visit Outlook.com by firing up your web browser, Edge, Chrome, Firefox, or whatever. It then opens a window onto your email that is provided by Outlook.com. Outlook.com, the website, can only be used to access Microsoft accounts. So if you've got a Hotmail account or a WebTV account or an Outlook.com account or a Live.com or a MSN.com account, those are all emails that you can then access here on the web using Outlook.com. But again, it's a website. It is not on your PC. You are visiting it using your browser. It is called Outlook.com. And I think it's important to remember that it is so dramatically different from the other outlooks. Unfortunately, what I hear repeatedly is people referring to Outlook when they mean outlook.com. By now, I hope you understand how dramatically different these two things are and how important the distinction is, particularly when it comes to trying to answer questions and solve problems. So, Outlook.com, a website that you can use to access your Microsoft account emails. Outlook from Microsoft Office, a program that you can install on your PC to access any email account. And apparently the new Windows Outlook, which is another email program that you can install on your PC to access any email account. It's confusing as mud. Which one do you want to use? Well, that kind of depends. If you are a power user, if you're in an office environment, you probably want Microsoft Office Outlook. It is the high-end Microsoft email program, and it's kind of been the standard in the workplace for many, many years. If you want a program installed on your PC and you want to stick with Microsoft software, then Windows Outlook actually looks to be a pretty reasonable program running on your PC. Remember, it is eventually going to replace the mail program that's already on your PC, and it's free. And finally, Outlook.com. If you just want to be able to access your email from anywhere by visiting a website, and you're only dealing with Microsoft email addresses, Outlook.com might be for you. I hope this clarifies things. Like I said, this is such a confusing mess. I'm continually frustrated at Microsoft's naming, and this is perhaps the worst situation I've ever encountered. For updates, for comments, for links related to this and more, visit askleo.com/1832. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.